Hello my friends and welcome to another Toy Robots video. Thundercats is an American media franchise, featuring a group of cat-like humanoid aliens. Join me, and together we will review this cartoon, the toys and near the end of the video, two extremely rare variants that not everyone is aware of. The original Thundercats show was animated in Japan while being produced, written and voice acted in the United States. The series was originally distributed by Rankin Bass Productions, then parent company Telepictures Corporation, which would later merge with Lorimar Productions in February 1986. Thundercats was based on Third Earth, which had the most beautiful scenery of any cartoon. Lion-O was the leader who was full of courage. He had a team he could depend on. The strong Panthro, the reliable Tigra and the beautiful Chitara. They helped him in his battle against the evil Mumra. The animation is amazingly detailed and general, the colors and backgrounds are very sophisticated, and the characters are all drawn wonderfully. The music is also wonderful, the theme tune is one of the most memorable in an animated show ever. The writing is very intelligent and thoughtful with a sense of adventure, and the storylines are incredibly deep and complex for a cartoon oriented basically for kids. Finally, the voice acting, which is superb, fit with the characters wonderfully, to create definitely one of the best cartoons of the 80s. In January 1989, Lorimar Telepictures was purchased by and folded into Warner Brothers, whose television syndication arm would eventually assume distribution of the show. Warner Brothers has owned the rights to the series and all Lorimar Telepictures programming from that point on. Amazing, don't you think? Before we dive into the toy line, please be sure to hit that subscribe button. We upload toy videos weekly in this channel. You can also support us or follow us in many ways. Now, we continue exploring this amazing line of toys. LJN was an American toy company and video game publisher. It was founded in 1970 by Jack Friedman and ran until 1994, when it was closed down and dissolved into Acclaim Entertainment. In the early 1980s, LJN was contracted to manufacture the Thundercats toy line. Unlike many other toys being produced at that time, the LJN Thundercats toy line was unique due to almost every toy having some sort of a bottlematic action. This feature, which made the toys extremely popular among children, was also employed by LJN in its previous toy line, Advanced Dungeons & Dragons. The toys were released in three waves over a span of 3 years, with each wave boasting new additions as well as re-releases of previous toys. Most of the toys came packaged along with a fold-out mini catalog, which advertised all the toys available in that year's release. With each new release, the catalogs were updated to include the new toys that were introduced. Series 1 of 1985 included the most important characters. The heroes, Lion-O, Panthro, Tigra and Chitara. And four villains, Mumra, Slith, Monkey and Jack Hellman. The backs of the Series 1 toy cards featured 8 figures, and hence they are often referred to as 8-back cards. Series 2 includes characters as Heck Human, Snowman of Hook Mountain, Tuska Warrior and many more characters were produced in 1986. Finally, Series 3 of 1987 included fan favorites Yaga, Bengali, Pumira, Lynx-O and many other characters. Is worth mentioning, two rare variants which came from Argentina, Bengali and Lynx-O, made by Playful with official license of LJN. Instead of using the LJN Bengali figures mold, Playful used a completely different mold for its figure, which was created from modification of the LJN Tigra old figure. They not only changed the paint job, the figure has many differences in the chest, the back, the arms and the elbows. Also, the Playful version had a completely different, axe-like, chrome hammer. In the case of Lynx-O, they used a completely different mold for its figure, which was created from modification of the LJN Yaga figure. In this case, not only changed the paint job, the figure has many differences also in the chest, the wrists and most noticeable in the head sculpt, which it was modified in many ways. Also, The playful version came together with a chrome-colored shield. Finally, another interesting variant came from France, where the Thundercats were known as Cosmocats, and the French releases of the LJN toys also bore that name on their cards and boxes. Thundercast was an amazing franchise that produced many toys throughout the 80s. There were also several comic book series produced in the US published by Marvel Comics through its Star Comics imprint in 1985. Well, my friends, that is all I have for you this time. I hope you liked this review of the awesome Thundercats. If you enjoyed this video and want to hear from me or my robot friends again, please be sure to hit that subscribe button before you go. Thank you for watching, and I will see you in our next video.